Hi, everyone, and welcome to Weather or Not, sponsored by TD Bank. I'm WABC Chief Meteorologist Lee Goldberg. It's been a minute, so I'm excited to speak with you again. I can't remember a time where things have been so active, whether it be earthquakes or eclipses or aurora borealis or wildfire smoke. There's so much going on atmospherically, and then, of course, just with the actual general weather situation that we've been having as we struggle to get into a consistently warm pattern. Obviously, we've left the chill, which is good news, but May hasn't delivered consistent warmth as sometimes it has in years past. Is that going to change the second half of the month? We'll deal with that. And now, of course, just like last year when we started to talk about getting into a groove of nicer weather and we have sunny skies to forecast at times, then we have to worry about other factors, like is wildfire smoke going to be another factor in our skies going into the spring. So we're going to touch on all of that in this edition of Weather or Not. So we thank so much for joining us. We're going to focus on some wet weather that we're going to deal with in the middle part of this week, get into your extended forecast into next weekend, and watch that wildfire smoke, which is thicker as we go into parts of the upper Midwest right now. So the state in Canada is that there are over 100 wildfires active, and there are roughly 40 that are not even contained at all. So you're seeing plumes of this smoke being directed by our steering winds into the upper Midwest. Right now, it's more upper Midwest, whether it's Wisconsin or parts of Minnesota or into Iowa, and it's not being pushed into the Northeast, at least for the time being. And I'll talk about the prospect of that happening down the road. There are two maps that you should get used to as we get into this season, this wildfire season in Canada, where we show you the wildfire smoke. One will be aloft, so that does it just look hazy here and our air quality isn't compromised, or is it near the surface? So this one that we're showing here is just labeled wildfire smoke, and we'll show it on Eyewitness News. You'll see how the density of that wildfire smoke is pushed into the upper Midwest and parts of the Great Lakes, while high pressure off our shore really deflecting that to the north. So not a factor in our weather just yet. Let's look at the near surface smoke, which looks a little bit different in its orientation. Not so much when it's here in the real trouble spots in Minnesota and Wisconsin and Iowa, but the trajectory of it. It's headed toward the heartland, where obviously it has been a super rough spring in terms of severe weather, in terms of flooding. So that's not aimed at our area yet. But I am a little concerned moving forward that with our weather pattern that we're currently seeing right now, that our source region of air masses is from Canada right now, is from the north and west. It's not that we've gotten into so many southwestern air masses or southwest winds where we're just warming up and we're getting the big humidity from down south and we're getting the big heat. Even when we try to warm up, we get this relief from the north and west. So if that's going to continue, and the wildfire situation is going to get worse because, listen, they're coming off their warmest winter across Canada on record, a snowpack that's below normal, and forecast high temperatures that are slated to be above normal in May and June. So let's just assume that the wildfire situation is not going to go away if we're going to continue in a pattern where our prevailing winds and weather systems periodically are going to come from the north and west, we're going to have some exposure to that. So just something to familiarize you again, because it's been a long time, we're going to continuously put the AQI stamp or a little medallion in the upper right-hand quadrant of our current condition. So for instance, today, our air quality is moderate at a 60, and it's really been in the good to moderate range for the most part as we've gone through the spring. Again, another thing that we'll be showing to you is the overall ranges. And this is just good to look back, because in that awful period when the air quality was at its poorest, in fact, record poor air quality, and across the globe, some of the poorest days were in the New York City area. When you talk about our air quality now in the maybe even 50 to 100 AQI level, it was over 400 that day back in June when we went back to an orange sky. So we're not forecasting anything like that, and it would actually be pretty amazing to even attain that again, even with the current situation that's evolving across parts of Canada. So those are the graphics to get familiar with again, and we'll be showing you on Channel 7. Our headlines moving forward. It's not as chilly as we had in points last week and even Mom's Day, which I hope you had a great Mother's Day, and we're stuck in the 50s for the most part. Our temperatures may be slightly below average, which by now is already in the lower 70s, believe it or not, our normal temperatures. But it will be comfortable. Not going to be excessively warm, but comfortable to pleasant. And on our wettest days, we'll be a little bit more below normal and struggle through the 60s. But I don't see a raw day in the 50s moving forward in the 7 to 10 day stretch. Our showers this week are going to reappear by Tuesday late in the day and Tuesday evening, although I don't think they're too widespread. And it really is a difficult forecast as we go even into Wednesday, which looks like a wet day overall, especially south of the city. But is it a washout? When I first started to look at some information over the weekend, I was leaning yes, but the closer we get to it, I don't think that that's necessarily a slam dunk. I think we will be in between systems to finish off the week, but unfortunately there's an unsettled stretch that will at least start the weekend. I'm hoping, you know, we can't seem to get a full great weekend, but can we do another 50-50 where this time Sunday would be the better day? That would be the extended forecast so far. So right now we have slow moving weather systems that are moving across the middle of the country. We have a weak little weather system going to our north right now, but it'll be pieces of this slow moving system in the middle of the country that will come eastward over time. And then it'll have a tough time exiting our coastline. So we hate when we use the S word in our weather forecast, stalled, because obviously it leaves you with a weather rut for a period of time. And that's what we're concerned about as we head into second half of this week and even into the upcoming weekend. A short-term future cast would indicate an encouraging look to the start of your Tuesday and into the late afternoon hours. But I would have the umbrella late day, especially west of New York City, and into Tuesday evening for some occasional scattered showers around. It certainly looks like the best threat is going to be west. As we go into the day on Wednesday, that system will be kind of traveling underneath us. So I think there'll be scattered showers that evolve into periods of rain for a while, and there'll be a better chance off to the south. But our future cast, if you're watching the maps right now on whether or not, you'll notice that it's not as bullish as it was on a widespread rain during the day on Wednesday. So while it's unsettled, maybe you hold off as long as you can on canceling those outdoor plans, because it may be not a total washout and more likely to see those showers off to the south. Now Thursday, again, this is a situation where this low is going to be slow to depart. Our winds are not favorable for rapid clearing, so it could be sluggish. So could there be a transition day where we have more showers in the morning and then an optimistic forecast would suggest we can dry out in the afternoon? Clearing, not sure just yet. So again, kind of a transition day there. Like the idea of Friday being in between fronts. It's actually Bronx week. So we're scheduled for our AccuWeather forecast to be live from the Bronx, and I like my chances of getting out there. I don't think it's a terribly warm day. We might be around the 70 degree mark, warmer temperatures inland. But once again, we are in between systems. It's not that there's clean clear out and an obvious beautiful day. It just looks like we're in between front. Our rainfall chances are way down, and hopefully we can get some clouds and sunshine that day and just have a nice pleasant May day after that. And that system to the west would arrive here as we go into the day on Saturday. Again, the precipitation amounts, the rainfall amounts for the late Tuesday into early Thursday time period have definitely trended down. Where I thought we could have half an inch to an inch, right now I'm in a forecast range which a couple of tenths of an inch to maybe 3/4 of an inch, 7/10, with the higher amounts being off to the north and west. So I don't think we're getting tremendous flooding rains or anything that I would issue an AccuWeather alert at this point that would disrupt your travel greatly. Let's look at the overall pattern. And the first thing you notice, just if you're looking at a jet stream map, and you don't have to be a meteorologist to do this, if you see a lot of ups and downs and waves in the jet stream, it's called amplified. And amplified is going to mean that storms are generally going to move slower, and you're going to have stretches where you might have to deal with extended unsettled stretches. And if you're in the right position, you get into great weather for several days. That's not the case this time. So at first glance, when we're looking at our storm tracks and our steering winds, look for dips or U-shaped orientations of the jet stream. So you can see one that's off the East Coast, little cool pocket. That was our weekend problem. And then you see the storminess that's going on across the middle of the country. When that little U is sharper, okay, you know, maybe it's closer to almost a tighter U. The bars of the U are closer together. It's a sharper dip in the jet stream. That would indicate maybe a stronger storm, okay? As this storm comes eastward, notice how it kind of opens up. It's kind of a wider, broad trough or dip in the jet stream. It indicates some weakening. So whatever intensity we're watching in the middle of the country, severe weather threat, flooding going down south, It's a lifting system that's weakening as it approaches us. So that's why we're not forecasting any serious weather. And that's really happened a lot. You know, sure, have we gotten into some thunderstorms and some occasional downpours, but we've been very fortunate to kind of get the leftovers of all these damaging and devastating storms over the middle of the country and the hundreds of tornadoes that we've seen. So here we are on Wednesday when it would be most unsettled, and then that disturbance is just slow to leave. Now notice there's not a closed circulation around that. That's significant. It's another sign of weakening. We call it more of an open wave or an open U that's getting offshore, kind of weak, but the thing is we are on the western side of it and still close enough that I'd be a little hesitant to forecast rapid improvement. That's why we're calling Thursday a transition day, and we're getting into Friday and suggesting, okay, we're probably in between systems. Hopefully that upper level dip or trough or low in the Atlantic is far enough offshore, gives us a chance to dry out a little bit and have a decent day. But notice, you know, there's another dip off to the west, and everything offshore just kind of expands as we go into the weekend, meaning Saturday would be a little unsettled, and then hopefully the little kicker from the west, all that warm air you see getting into the Great Lakes, hopefully that ridge or upside down U, that bubble in the jet stream there, that building ridge would be enough to shove that storminess out to sea, allowing us to have for a nicer Sunday. Things can get blocky in spring. You know, you have to be careful about speeding things up too much in a forecast. So a lot of times when I'm looking at situations like this, I might forecast something a little slower than some of the guidance is predicting. So I'd be a little hesitant to promise what it's showing right now, which would indicate a drier, nicer Sunday, second half of the weekend. So just something to think about as you look at the 7 day, look at the overall trend. Do we dry it out on Sunday? Does it look like it's looking cloudier and looking damper, or, you know, we're slowing things down? That's something you can get an idea of just by looking at the day-to-day trend of the 7 day, which is always important. It's always, it's good to look at a snapshot to get an idea of what you're planning for and what the weather might be, but also look at how is that forecast trending over time? Because a lot of times we don't want to make a dramatic shift 4 or 5 days out in the forecast, because I don't want a windshield wiper in the forecast. I want to make a call on it and then watch its progression. So watch the trend over a few days to get an idea. And I'll also let you in on, we're doing it right now, and whether or not we do it every day on our weathercast on Channel 7. We give you an idea, sort of insight on how the forecast building blocks are coming together. As we go into early next week, while the details are difficult to work out, doesn't look like there's anything terribly stormy around us, but it's just really interesting that this ongoing trend is for warm air to build over the middle of the country, a little piece of that air mass to come eastward, but never getting into the full-fledged warm air and always getting some pressure from cooler patterns or cooler pockets of air that are over central or eastern Canada. And you can see that into early next week. So I just don't see any major warm-ups. I mean, seasonable is great this time of year. You can get into the lower 70s, but I don't see anything way above normal if you're craving that summer warmth and the beach weather to really kick in on a consistent basis. Same message even into late next week. That upper low is well off the Carolina coast. That's great for us, but I just think it screams more pleasant fair weather after that, but not necessarily, you know, a big-time warm-up. And that is echoed in the Climate Prediction Center's long-range forecast. This is the 8 to 14-day forecast, so we're looking into late May here. What are the signals? Below normal temperatures in the northern plains and the western Great Lakes. And for us, near to maybe slightly above normal at times, although I would err more toward the near normal conditions. In terms of rainfall, no huge signal for soakers in this. That's really over the middle of the country, and also over the southeast as well. So we'll definitely look for our rainfall to be periodic, but not getting into drenchers like we had in the late winter and into the early spring. So that's something we'll be watching. Here's just a snapshot of what the 10-day trend looks like. Again, you can see more blue, which would indicate below normal temperatures. I know 70 looks pleasant, but you know, by that time, as we get into the middle of May, your normal temperatures are getting into the low and middle 70s. So there's a little splash of warmth as we go into early next week, and then we settle back in, as I suggested. Doesn't mean that it's wet. It just means that our temperatures aren't forecast to be way above average. It could also be wind flow, because remember, our water temperatures are still slowly climbing through the 50s, so any type of marine influence and you're going to struggle with your overall temperatures. Just because you're tuning into Weather or Not, we give you an early look at a 7-day that we'll build as we go through the rest of the week, and it's unsettled later Tuesday into Wednesday. Hopefully, we can see a better Thursday afternoon. Friday may be your best bet late week before we get unsettled to the start of the weekend, and then on Sunday, again, I don't want to promise clearing yet. I'm encouraged by us drying out on Sunday, but I don't want to totally forecast a dry day from start to finish, given the way this blocky, slow pattern is looking. So that's the thinking so far in this edition of Weather or Not. Some other housekeeping, the Aurora Borealis. I hope you got a chance to see that. I have never seen as strong a geomagnetic storm since 2003 when we had it. So it's been over 20 years here in the tri-state area. And it is a really good gauge moving forward, because I know there's been several times over even the last year where we've come on and we said, okay, you know, there's an outside shot of seeing the northern lights in our viewing area, especially away from city lights. And it's really hard. You see a faint purple or a faint green. But these were brilliant displays that went all the way down to Key Largo, Florida. I saw some amazing pictures from that. So that's a great gauge moving forward. One thing is, we're still in a solar max until we go into next year. Our solar activity looks to be pretty impressive. And in this case, there were five what we call CMEs, or coronal mass ejections, meaning an explosion of solar material headed toward the Earth. And three out of those five were able to merge and create this super solar storm to get us into a G5 level geomagnetic storm, the highest on the scale, a KP index of 9. So those are the numbers we're going to look to if we're going to get a repeat in something like that as we move forward. So in the solar max, there still should be some opportunities going forward. We got spoiled by some cloud cover at times, but there were definitely a lot of great observations around the tri-state, and thank you for sending those in so we could show the rest of our viewers. That's always been on my bucket list. I didn't get a chance to see it. We were fogged in where I lived, and we're under cloud cover because I was not in town one of the days. So the Aurora Borealis continues to elude me, but I'm excited about seeing it. I guess maybe the eclipse was a gift enough this year, because I got a spectacular view of that from Burlington, Vermont. We'll keep you posted on everything celestial, everything right down here on the Earth's surface. Again, so far, no major summer warm-ups in sight. It's only a matter of time, so just pack your patience, and hopefully this trend of unsettled weekends, we're just getting it out of the way so the Memorial Day weekend things straighten out, and is the first moment that we know some of the details about that Memorial Day stretch, we'll get them to you on Weather or Not. Thanks so much for viewing Weather or Not and being with us. We'll see you next time. Rain or shine.